Hey there, welcome to this Notion tutorial where I'll show you how to track your finances in Notion. It's going to be really simple and straightforward. First thing first, let's turn this page into full width. Now add the table view and name it accounts. Delete the text property and go to the database settings to hide the vertical lines. Let's start by creating an example account called bank account and add a number property for the starting balance. You can update the number format to your preferred currency. You can also resize the column width of each property to make it more compact and then add an example starting balance. Now let's give our bank account a new page icon. Next, let's add another table view and name it expenses. Add the date property for the transaction date and the number property for the expense amount. And then a select property for the expense category. You can choose to add as many options as you need, like food, transportation, education, and health. You can also choose to color code your options or use the same color tone for a minimal look. Let's add some example expenses before we connect our databases. Give it a name, assign a transaction date, put in an amount, and set a category. Now let's add a new property called relation and choose the accounts database. Toggle on to show on accounts and give the relation property a new icon. Then add its expenses to the respective bank account. To make it easier to add a page icon, we can create a simple page template for our expenses database. We can name it new expense and give it the icon we want. Now we can easily apply this template if we enter an expense page. For our existing pages, you can easily select all the pages and configure it to the same page icon. Since the expense property does not show any useful information, we can choose to hide it. Instead, we'll add a rollout property to calculate the sum of all our expenses related to this account. Choose the expenses relation, the amount property, then calculate the sum. Now let's duplicate our expenses database to be used as our incomes database. Rename the database title to incomes, as well as our example pages, and also the value of the amount. Change the select property from category to type to label our incomes by the type of income. Update the options accordingly to salary, investment, self-employment, or whatever is relevant to you. Now let's fix the accounts database properties by renaming the relation property to incomes. Before giving it a new property icon, we can show both the expenses and incomes relation property as minimal to prevent it from cluttering the view. Now, let's add a rollout property to calculate the total incomes entering this account. Choose the incomes relation, then the amount property, and lastly calculate the sum. Lastly, let's add a formula property called current balance. We'll give it a new property icon before editing a simple formula where we add up our starting balance and total incomes, then subtract our total expenses. Then we just have to set it to our preferred currency and we are done. You can also choose to reorder the properties to how you want to see them on each account page. Back on the home page, we can choose to show the properties we want to see, like the total incomes and current balance. On the other hand, we can choose to hide the starting balance property. And that's it for part 1. In part 2, I'll show you how to use buttons to add repeating expenses and salary. We'll also track your monthly budgets and other features like transfers between accounts. So if you have any questions, do leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on part 2. Feel it.